I don't know what that means. Robert Pod? I don't know what that means. Robert Potter, I guess? Robert Pod? I don't know what that means. Robert Potter?
Thank you. This is your wake-up call. Prepare to die. Welcome to Trivia Murder Party. There is no social mixer in our hotel ballroom. You've been lured into a murderous game of trivia. Only one of you will survive. And that one survivor better leave this hotel a glowing review online. I will not be screwed over by TripAdvisor again. All right, first question. In the Jules Verne novel, Journey to the Center of the Earth, how did the protagonist attempt to reach the center of the Earth? Use your device to answer the question. Time's almost up. And the correct answer is... who got the question right? The rest of you, it's time. Welcome to the killing room. It's the pegs game. You're going to drop down this board and try to avoid the death zones. Someone needs to pick which slots are death zones. Hey, you, pick the landing slots that kill. Okay. Let the games begin. Pick a spot to drop from. Pick a spot or I'll pick it for you. Ooh, I just love watching this one. Well, now I hate this game. Moving on. Hey look, I made the elevator a scoreboard moment. Pretty cool, huh? Let's try another one. When was the first submarine attack? Almost out of time. Who picked this? The rest of you, I want to show you something. Salutations! Welcome back to the killing room. Ah, the lost art of letter writing. I'm going to dictate a message to you. Write down as much of what I say as you can. The player who writes the fewest of my words will die. Okay, let me lean back in this chair and get my feet up. And we begin. It pains me deeply to have to write to you in my current emotional state, but here we are. While my previous visits to your store have been nothing short of delightful, my last trip filled me with disappointment and rage. Please understand that I will be buying my scented candles elsewhere. Time's up! Now let me just see what we have here with a quick... And here's how you did! Yikes! One of you did real bad! I can't send this letter, are you kidding me? You're back! Okay, so... don't freak out! But you're a ghost now. Keep playing and you just might steal someone else's life force and win the game. Let's keep moving. According to averages, who's got the biggest brain? Time's running out. Who picked this? Everyone is wrong. Time for consequences. Congrats! All of you are entered in my scratch ticket giveaway. Scratch and find $3 signs to live. If you keep scratching, I'll give you cash for every dollar sign you find. But if you scratch off even one skull, you die. Get to scratching! Come on, you could scratch more. The contest is almost over. We know what a losing ticket means. We're here. The final round is close. Next question. What is ROM made from? Almost out of time. Who picked this? Only a ghost got it wrong. Lucky guesses. Let's try another one. Where is the stadium for the New York Giants? Time's almost up. Who picked this? One of you is still alive. Follow me. Hopefully you can defend yourself from ESP. Type in an answer that fits this category. Everyone else will answer too. And if anyone matches you, you die. Write your answers now. Time's almost up. Now, let's see if there are any matches. If you get your mind red, you get your mind dead. Ah, crap, I killed everybody? I guess I'll bring one of you back. It's kind of arbitrary, but you had the most money. Anywho, the time has come. Congrats on making it here alive, but can you escape? I'm going to give you a category. Has an exoskeleton. Tap each answer that fits the category and then press submit. Time is almost up. Let's see the right answers. You advance one space for every correct answer. You're on your way to escaping. Ah, but it's not just you. If a ghost catches you, they'll steal your life force. Then they can try to escape and win the game. Here's everyone's next question. And ghosts get a third choice to help them catch up to you. Time is almost up. recognize swimming positions. Animals that hibernate. Don't look behind you. It's only darkness. Venomous animals. Time is almost up. The darkness approaches. IKEA products. Don't look back because there's a ghost right there. Dating apps. Let's just call that a fluke. Agatha Christie mysteries. Time is almost up. Wow, I don't know who's gonna win. Andy Warhol art pieces. A ghost stole your life force. Brass instruments. Another life swap. Not so fast. You need a perfect answer for your final escape. And that includes the third answer choice now, too. Time is almost up. You have to get all the right answers to escape. Welcome back. Remember, breakfast is 6 a.m. to 9:30, the pool's open till 11 p.m., and of course, murder is 24 hours. First question. What's that song that always makes me cry from the movie musical Once? your device to answer the question. Time's running out. And the correct answer is... who got the question right? The rest of you, come with me. Welcome to room 113. The hairdryer's broken, sorry. This is my tattoo parlor. I know a serial killer with crazy tattoos is like totally cliche, but whatever. Create a new tattoo on my back by drawing on your device. Yeah. Right there. That was really transformative for me. Now vote for your favorite tat. The artist with the fewest votes will die. Vote already. What did we decide? Ugh, this ink has got to go. I think it's pretty clear what I have to do now. Let's keep moving. What do sumo wrestlers throw in the air to purify their ring? Almost out of time. Who picked this? The rest of you, time for consequences. Welcome to room 217. Time to try to save yourself with a password. Enter a real four-letter word with your device. Don't make it easy. If someone cracks your password, you die. Now everyone else will try to crack the passwords. As a team, guess either password on your device. You get a clue if your guess has a letter in the right spot. I will reward you all for every password you crack. Don't be greedy about what letters you figured out. Let everyone know. Time's almost up. Ooh, you got hacked, son. Let's try another one. Which of the following is part of your outer or visible ear? Time's running out. Who picked this? One of you is still alive. Follow me. Let's get our math on! Do as much math as you can before time runs out. Everyone else will be playing along. If one of them does better than you, it's punishment time. Let's go! How's that math going, Matthew McConaughey? No pressure, but time's almost up. As we say in team sports, you were mathematically eliminated. We're here. The final round is close. Next question. What's peppermint? Time's almost up. Who picked this? I want to show you something. I hope you like magic tricks. Pick a space inside the box to hide. Some spots are better than others, but don't overthink it. Any good magic trick needs some helpful volunteers. Good news, I'm giving you a sword. On your device, choose a row or a column to run your sword through. Sword is a weird sounding word, right? Swords. Swords. Magic! What's the point? Only one of you is still alive. You know what that means. Glad to see you're the one to make it here alive, but will you be the one to escape? Here's your first category. Clouds. Tap each answer that fits the category and then press submit. Time is almost up. Let's see the right answers. Types of poems. Time is almost up. Next question. Galaxies. Antelopes. Don't fall behind. Here comes the darkness. Geometric angles. Time is almost up. I'm going too easy on you. Here comes the next question. Gluten-free. can't outrun that ghost forever. Disney animated movies. Not what I had in mind. The tables have turned. This will slow you down. If you want to break through that barrier, you'll need a perfect answer to this question. And that includes the third answer choice now, too. Time is almost up. You have to get all the right answers to escape. More stolen life force. Books in L. Frank Baum's Oz series. Melissa McCarthy movies.
V.
Steve and Dave use eToro to trade cryptocurrencies. Steve does extensive research in order to find the next Bitcoin. Steve and Dave use eToro to trade cryptocurrencies. Steve does extensive research in order to find the next Bitcoin. Steve and Dave use eToro to trade cryptocurrencies. Steve does extensive research in order to find the next Bitcoin. Steve and Dave use eToro to trade cryptocurrencies. Steve does extensive research in order to find the next Bitcoin. Steve and Dave use eToro to trade cryptocurrencies. Steve does extensive research in order to find the next Bitcoin. Steve and Dave use eToro to trade cryptocurrencies. Steve does extensive research to find the next Bitcoin. Steve and Dave use eToro to trade cryptocurrencies. Steve does extensive research to find the next Bitcoin. Steve and Dave use eToro to trade cryptocurrencies.
If you're tired of reading about other people getting rich in the stock market, this might be a good day for you. And that's because The Motley Fool is offering a full 50% off its top stock picking service, Motley Fool Stock Advisor, plus a complete membership fee back guarantee. So if you've heard about the fools and their market tripling stock picks, you probably don't want to miss checking this out. And there's a good reason why they're offering this 50% off discount today, which I'll get to in a moment. You see?
What's up? My name's Technoba, here for Troubleshoot, and welcome back to another video. In today's video, I'll be showing you how you can set up your own Valheim private server to get you and your friends all playing. It's very similar to a Minecraft server in that we'll be downloading a dedicated server and we'll be running it off of a local computer. Then we'll have to allow it through our firewall and port forward for other people to connect outside of our local internet. Note that unlike paid platforms, you'll have to be running the server on your own hardware, meaning you'll have to keep your computer on and running as long as you'd like the server to be up and running. So with all of that aside, let's go ahead and start. First of all, open up Steam on an account that you own Valheim on. Why is that? Well, you'll see Valheim down here, but if we click the button at the top and click Tools to enable this, we'll be able to search for Valheim once again, and this time we'll see.
role models. We're not mad scientists, we're glad scientists. Here at the lab, we've spent years searching for the genetic magic that makes each and every human a truly unique individual. But that was hard, so we found a shortcut. We theorize every friend group has some version of the smart one, the popular one, the troubled loner who I can change. You get the idea. And these roles make it a lot easier to figure people out with science. You guys are going to match your fellow test subjects to the roles that fit them best. My lovely assistant will put all the data into the tubes, and at the end, we'll crunch the numbers and tell each of you who you really are. Now, have you all changed into your little paper gowns? Good, let's do this. Everyone vote for the category that looks the most interesting, preferably something you all know a bit about. Unfinished book on my bookshelf are each of you. So, on your device, you've got the names of your fellow lab rats. Drag each one to the role you think fits them best. That includes yourself. Oh, and you'll see a little 99% sign next to each role. Tap that to lock in the answer you're 99% certain will match what everyone else picks. I'll make it worth your while if you're right, so make sure to pick someone. When everyone's given out their roles, we'll check out the results. Let's see who's who. Show me the votes. Get rid of the outliers. We have our winner.
Yeah.
I like to keep my guinea pigs motivated, so I'll give you guys these nutritious science pellets. Whatever your answers, match the group. Whoever has the most at the end is my lab rat of the month. Plus, they keep your pelt shiny. We've got some 99% bonus pellets to award. Subjects who already have a role can't get this one, so we'll take out these votes.
Yippee!
Here's where we landed. And here's how you're doing on science pellets. Just a reminder, I'll reward you with pellets when your answers match the group or when you do the best in a tiebreaker experiment. Keep that in mind if you want to be the winning test subject. What's our next category? Which character from The Office are you? Let the truth-telling begin. And make sure to tap that 99% next to the role you're sure you're right about. Let's see that data. Right, that's a tie. Time for another test to see who gets this roll. Vote on your devices now. The subject with the most votes gets the roll. And they tied again. Wonderful. You had some strong feelings on this, and I trust you implicitly. So we'll wait your vote a little more. Don't tell my boss. Performing the best in this experiment is definitely worth a few science pellets. Don't say I never did anything for you. Ooh, still no roll for you after all that data. Don't worry. I've got a Plan B roll that might speak to you. Everyone vote on which roll this controversial subject deserves. No way of knowing how you feel about this. You get the roll and some science pellets. All right, we've got our lineup. Oh, and you? You are nailing this. You know more about your friends than you probably should. Okay, we've got some solid info on each of you. Now let's run the numbers and see if anything interesting pops up. I can tell from your roles, you two are complete opposites. From a very specific point of view, anyway. Science demands an experiment to see which of you is better for science. You get one wish, but have to phrase it very carefully. What do you wish? I want both of you to write an answer that fits the trait above your head. The rest of you will decide who wins. This is what we got. Vote on your devices now. Makes sense to me. Okay, what will our last category be? Which of these reasons for wearing a suit are you? Okay, make those matches. Thank you. Let's find out who you are. That 99% guess paid off. Last one picked for a role, huh? We've all been there. I've got a backup role that might fit you better. Everyone vote on which role should go to this perplexing subject. You really earned this. There's our lineup. One last thing before we end the experiment. Let's see if there are any more interesting patterns in those roles. Based on your roles, you're total opposites. At least in this one extremely specific way. We're not leaving here until we find out which of you is better at being you. You're speed dating. What's your attention-getting opening line? Enter your answer on your device. There it is. Vote on your devices now. The results are in. You guys, your roles tell me you share a common personality trait. I can't stand not knowing who's better. Hello has been retired. You are allowed to pick the new universal greeting. What is it? Answer the prompt on your devices, and we'll settle this once and for all. There you have it. Vote on your devices now. Ooh, too close to call. Honestly, the paperwork will be a lot easier if we just go with you. Final piece of data. Allow me to present your final roles, determined by everything your fellow guinea pig said about you. And our lab rat of the month with the most total science pellets is... Thank you.
Welcome aboard. I'm Chuck Hull, the ship's captain and MC. Grab your dummy and sign in. Any time now. Any time now. Gather round, comedians. Here's tonight's itinerary. We're gonna write some jokes and then test them out on stage. But first things first, it's brainstorming time. Before we jump into the jokes, let's do a little writing exercise to get inspired. On your device, you'll be prompted to write various topics like animals, people, or objects. Fill in whatever you think has a lot of comedic potential. If another player uses one of your topics in a winning joke, you'll get some bonus points. Generate as many as you can. You have 45 seconds, starting now. This writing exercise is ending soon. Follow the steps on your device to write two jokes. Trust your instincts, unless they're bad. Move on to your second joke soon. How about it, folks? A big round of applause for that hip-hop group, Nautical by Nature. Now, let's switch gears to some comedy. Let's welcome our first comedian to the stage. Remember to say your catchphrase. Which comedian told a better joke? Ahoy! It's our next comic!
See, not for you, but for you, not ready. Ready, not see, ready, see.
Let us know which joke you liked the most. And some credit to you. Okay, up next. And a tip of the hat to you. All right, let's hear it for our next comedian. Some points for you as well. Let's see who's on top and who is scraping the bottom of the barrel. If you're at the top, that means you're the headliner right now. Everyone is on board to write another round of jokes. If you haven't started your second joke yet, now would be the time. These comics know the ropes, so how can I not have them back? K-N-O-T. Not. Eh? Get up here, you goofs. Which comedian told a better joke? Vote now! Keep this joke boat moving and welcome our next comic to the stage. Who won this joke off? Place your vote now! Make some noise for our next comic. Set up. Let's keep it going for our next comic. Okay, you jokers, let's tally the scores. If you're currently losing, might I suggest writing funnier jokes? Just something to think about. we're sinking again. There's no time to write jokes from scratch. So, here's the plan. Let's rewrite another comic's joke. You'll use the same setup, but we'll attempt to write a funnier punchline. The better the original joke did, the more points you'll earn for beating it. Can you steal the spotlight before the boat sinks? Let's find out. Do not panic, but do welcome our comedians back to the stage. Did they successfully beat this joke? Vote now. Which punchline is better? Comes out on top in this survival of the funniest.